Now, speaking about understanding the fabric of the universe, SpaceIL is gearing up for a special announcement today following the teaser of their second Bereshit lunar lander earlier this week. And here with more, we have SpaceIL co-founder Yariv Barash. Thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you. It's my pleasure.
All right. So first of all, I understand that the teaser was bringing us to today. What's the big news?
So we basically started announced the next Bereshit spacecraft. Bereshit 2 is the temporary name. And, you know, we are Israelis, so it's going to be bigger, better, and more exciting than Bereshit 1.
What's changed exactly since the first Bereshit mission? You know, what have we adapted after, you know, crashing into the Sea of Serenity?
Well, you know, it's like going first time to the Olympics and getting a silver medal. This time we're aiming for gold. So basically we're going to send three different spacecrafts to the moon. We're going to have an orbiter and two landers attached to it. And then the orbiter will be releasing the landers. Each one will make a landing on the moon in a different time, in a different location. And then you'll also have the orbiter orbiting the moon for years. So you're going to have both double the scientific impact of two landers, as well as an ongoing educational mission where kids from all over the world will be able to operate the orbiter for many years.
Wow. All right. Can you speak a little bit about what some of the participating scientists, school children, et cetera, might, you know, what kind of experiments they're sending you?
So we still haven't announced that. We are still open for a few ideas. Each one of the lander will have its own scientific mission, as well as the orbiter itself. And, you know, just stay tuned as we release more information.
Well, and of course, again, obviously, I'm sure SpaceIL and IAI and anyone else working on this project has been working hard to fix the thruster issue or the connection mm-hmm. issue that occurred last time. Are you confident that it's been fixed?
So, yeah, we've got amazing partners from the Israeli Aerospace Industries, as well as the Israeli Ministry of Science and the Israeli Space Agency. And we are aware of the problems we had in the first Bereshit. We had some very deep analysis of what went wrong. Actually, the thrusters worked perfectly. The problem was in the avionics that prevented the main thruster from firing again after the spacecraft performed the reset. And that's, you know, that's going to be easy to fix. The main thing now is building it again and making it better on, you know, across the board, not that specific malfunction.
All right. Well, just as in during the first launch, I'll be watching live with my fingers crossed. Thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you.
Good luck.